South Station.
I'm back, bitches.
And so when did you text her? When was the last time you texted her? Did she text you?
No, I called her. I talked to her on the phone. She called me.
Jimmy, I don't know why this is playing. This sounds impressive.
Oh,
Ronnie, how do you like the chowder?
Delicious.
In 10 weeks, we make $14,000.
This part's gonna be fine.
But he looks most different.
The one up front?
Yep.
All set?
So, my neighbor got a new pool toy.
Right.
I think he thought his pool was a little bigger than it is.
Dear God! Oh my God, it's gigantic!
It's so good to see you, Bill.
It's nice to see you, too.
Yeah. Where's Peter?
Hi, Pete. You like to get rid of it.
He likes to get rid of it.
Oh, you want to get rid of your hiccups? Okay, you'll get rid of it.
If we scare you, Peter, if we scare you, you'll get rid of it. Did it work?
And I are quite happy leading a middle.
It's him! It's him! It's Daddy!
A mess, I'm telling
you. Boston is a traffic mess?
It's bad, bad, bad.
Have you got the air conditioner on?
Of course I do.
Oh, good,
I'm not sparing any expense.
All right.
The Continental is still open?
Oh, yeah. I go. My father used to like this place.
You pick up dames.
Now, here's the... Keep going straight. Yeah, you need to cut over. Yeah. Use your blinker.
And
you know, to bury people today, how much it costs? Oh, my God, already.
I don't remember any of this.
I remember this. All right, park anywhere.
Yeah, where the hell are you supposed to put your car?
So you're saying she's in here?
Yes.
I see a lot of Elizabeths, but not the right one. Never in the same place. We're looking for the grave. Eddie found it.
Yep, give him a dollar.
I'm giving Eddie a dollar for finding it.
She was on a lot of magazines then, a lot. So I said, I'm gonna buy that. And that night, the number came out of one, $250.
Thank you, Madonna.
Thank you, Madonna.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bob's Market. Lincoln School. We used to call the kids Stinkin' Lincolns. This is St. Mary's School. We used to call them the St. Mary's Fairies. The Decius BB School. They called us the BB Babies. This used to be a hardware store, and this is where I used to catch the train to go to Emerson College. I commuted all 4 years. What the heck? Where's Hinchy's? I used to get my comic books there. This is where my next door neighbor, Mrs. Foley, was hit by a car and killed. And she was a crossing guard. And this park that's here is named after her now. And this park is right next door to St. Mary's Church, where I went for many, many years. My parents got married here. This is the spot where a truck came barreling around the corner, whizzing by like this. It was carrying concrete, and one of the concrete blocks flew out of the truck and landed right on my leg, and I fell to the ground. Truck took off. I didn't get the license plate. Could have been a millionaire if I had sued. When I was a Cub Scout, we raced cars in the Soapbox Derby here at the First Congregational Church. The BB Estate. Down here in the grounds, we held a science fair when we were kids. This is right next to the BB School. This was not here when I was a kid. Isn't this nice? We didn't have it. We had a school picture taken out here. Maintenance man, could you please fix this? This is the side of the school, and this is the notorious behind the school alley. We weren't supposed to be back here, but we'd come here anyway. This is where we had kindergarten, and then you'd move up first grade, second grade. These are the doors that lead to the auditorium, and it was the first stage I was ever on. Right through here, can you see it? We used to run out to the street here when the ice cream man would come. So about where I'm standing now is where in sixth grade, Mr. Kahn's used to take us out here to play softball. And, you know, a lot of the kids were good and they'd hit the ball really far. Then I would come up to bat with the lefty. And Mr. Kahn, standing right over there, would go, "Come on, kids. Come on, everybody move forward. Move forward. It's Billy." And making me feel totally self-conscious. And I'm like, feeling like the loser. I almost always bunted, but whatever. You had to do that to bring attention to the fact that I wasn't good. F you, Mr. Kahn's. My teacher, Mrs. Morrison, took us out to this lot where we joined all the classes of the school in a giant circle. And we sang songs. And two of the kids, James Orsino and Jeffrey Green, caused a lot of trouble and ran around the circle and screamed and yelled. So we go back into class, and Mrs. Morrison stares at all of us. And her face turns totally red, and she screams, "How could you? You boobs! You nincompoops!" My brother Larry and I would walk these train tracks all the way to Melrose Highlands to buy comic books. Shaw's, where's Sarah Tiny's? I'll tell you, I still feel the excitement like when I was a kid going down this alley with my mother, where you take the corner and go to Brigham's and have a hot fudge sundae. Nothing like it. Can't wait to have another one right now. Where's Brigham's? What the hell's Brugger's Bagels? CVS, where's Grant's? I used to love Grant's.
Hey, welcome to Buckaloo's in Melrose.
Candy! Well, this is Memorial Hall, where I did my very first show Auntie Mame. We're trying to get into Memorial Hall, no success. Caruso's was here. Best meatball sub ever. All gone. This is El Pond. I used to cross it when it was frozen solid to get to school. That's Melrose Wakefield Hospital where I was born. This is right next to El Pond. We called it the hill. And when we were kids, we used to roll down the hill down to the bottom. One of my favorite things to do as a kid.
And try to get up.
Holy cow!
Did you get the screams?
It feels like LSD.
Here we are, Melrose High. So many memories. Inside the auditorium. We are not supposed to be here.
Look.
We've snuck in. It's a clue. This is so Scooby-Doo. Roar! Jimmy found the light switch. Oh my God. Look how much nicer this theater is. Gorgeous. We all graduated on this field. For me, 1979. Me and some friends used to go under the bleachers and smoke pot, drink, and play spin the bottle. While we were in junior high school, oh, we were rebels.
Let's see if I remember. Let's see if it pointed at
it's
a guy.
Right.
If it pointed at a guy, we'd say, rain check. Okay. Oh!
That's awesome.
Talk to you later.
All right.
It was wonderful to talk to you again, Joe. I love talking to you again. It was a real treat.
That's a pleasure for me, Bill. You take care.
You too.
Okay.
My brother Larry and I went running one day, and it's here when he kept going and I stopped and I threw up. I could not keep up. Here it is, my childhood home on Vinton Street. It was blue, now it's white. And across the street where Aunt Eunice lived, and I used to climb those stairs.
I want those cookies, Aunt Eunice. So here I am, 175 West Emerson, where I grew up. Spent a lot of time here. And we have the park right across the street. The house looked very different. It was dark and gray, and now it's beautiful.
This is the tree that I used to climb as a kid. We used to go way up. That hill back there we thought was so huge. We used to sled down that hill. And look how tiny it is. The Barneses lived here. It was covered with trees. It was old. It was like a haunted house. And now it's glorious. Right across the street were our neighbors. The Zelinskys, they had a monkey in the backyard. Garnis Market, right down the street from our house. I remember it well. The Melrose Public Library, where I spent a lot of my childhood.
What you reading?
It's like being on the subway.
This is my favorite part of Boston, by the water.
Yeah.
when I'm in the Boston Common, I always think of all the witches that were hanged on trees here back during the witch trials.
From Massachusetts, the English begin to arrive in the early 1600s, and right away they bring a very big change. They bring guns, they bring Bibles, and they bring sickness.
They've got trees from every state in the United States.
Yeah. The public gardens. I practiced many a monologue and scene for college acting class right here in this corner of the public gardens.
It was really nice having you here.
Thank you. Where's your car?
I left the car at home, so we'll take the bus into town.
We should have parked it somewhere.
Yeah, parking is wicked expensive.
Oh my God. Who needs a car?
That's what I say. I don't need no car.
You're wicked smart.
So good.
Comics. Collectibles. Oh my God, Madonna. My father is going to love this. You think I'm kidding? He's gonna do it. You are gonna do it. Careful. Yes!
Alright, now get your bag.
Oh, very good. Over the river and through the woods to grandfather's. Is it grandfather or grandmother? Grandmother. To the old bag's house we go. Aren't you gonna say, come on in?
Come on in.
Hurry up.
Welcome.
I've never seen this before.
Well, here it is, Emerson's famous wall. We used to sit here and meet, talk, have a great time. I think I'll sit down again. Remember, God, how's this doing here? This wasn't here. So we used to have a great time. Jesus Christ. It's not the same.
Copley Plaza.
Like, can you imagine those little octopuses that aren't cooked and all that?
I wouldn't want to eat them when they're cooked, but I'm certainly not going to eat them when they're not cooked. They're the wrong texture.
I hate sushi.
Oh, the idea of eating something.
But why are we in the minority? Because everybody loves it.
I don't know. The texture is wrong for me, and I also don't want to end up with some sort of parasitic infection.
No, thank you.
That just wigs me out.
I'm on my brother Richard's porch, and it's really sunny and warm. And the reason I'm out here is because he has the air conditioning on too high and it's freezing in the house. So I decided to just enjoy the beautiful weather.
You like sweeties?
Lobster! So we were talking to Larry on the phone yesterday, and he says he's in very poor health. He's falling apart.
What?
Yes. He was like the healthiest of all of us.
I know. He was the runner, the exerciser, the athlete. You know, he's the only one that has.
He says nothing's the same. He said his memory is going.
Good God. Is that what I have to look forward to?
I'm just like, Larry, what?
Good God.
Holy cow! Go ahead.
Have you ever been to Milk and Cream Bar?
No, and what is it?
It's this ice cream place that they infuse cereal into like a vanilla base or milk based ice cream. It's really good.
Isn't that like when they talk about when all the cereal is gone, the milk tastes like the cereal? I mean, is that the idea?
I think it's just more to get like the... This thing's annoying.
Hey. Good morning. God, Richard, you dumped like a boatload of syrup on those French toast.
Hey, listen, the syrup's included. I'll use as much as I want.
I think what's been really striking for me is the peace and quiet that I've found in while staying at all three of my brother's houses, especially at night. It's just beautiful. I sleep all the way through, which I usually don't do in New York, so I enjoy that. Oh, hi! There's a little friend here. Hi! Can I pick you up? Hello. I rarely hold dogs, so I don't really know what I'm doing. Yeah, but it's been so nice, right? Nice, peace and quiet. Okay, that's enough of that.